it's MCLegendary52 here, and today I am going to be doing a mod review, which I haven't done in a long time. I've been doing, you know, Herobrine's Mansion and all that other stuff. For this mod review, if we can get to at least 600 likes on this, then that would be greatly appreciated. So, basically the mod I'm going to be going over today is called the Malice's Doors mod. So let's just get into this. Dang it, Thunder, why? Okay. So this mod adds in all different kinds of doors, new machines, more weather, not literally though. Let me just turn down my sound, because that's going to start to annoy me in a second. But it also adds in door animations, so if I just right click on my entrance to the mod house, it, you know, it kind of swings open like a regular door. And you don't have to right click both doors, you just one and then boom, it opens both. So before we go into our not secret anymore place in there, I'm going to be going over some of the doors that it adds in. So first I'm going to be going over the 1.8 vanilla doors. And to craft these, it's basically the different types of wood and a regular wood crafting table. You can do that, well, now you can, but if you were in, you know, regular 1.7, you couldn't do that. So, it's pretty much the same, they just look a little different, you know, all these kinds. They have the same animation as the regular door animations. I have another mod, but that's only because of something I built. Anywho, I already took those. Let's go into the doors that this adds in. And it adds in quite a few doors. I don't know why I have that in there. And as you can see, I have one of the doors on this. So I'm going to be using this mod in some of my other mod reviews for, like, mod reviews with mobs. So, the first one I have, which is right here, is the jail door. Basically slides open like that, and that sound has been being made. Okay, and then it's the same thing, and it depends on how you place them is where it will go. So if, I don't know, this one goes into that door, this one goes into there, okay. This one goes into there, so it's based on how you place it. Next we have a curtain. You basically just place it wherever you don't want someone to see. You can't walk through it when it's closed, but when it's open, it has this cool little animation. It's not, it doesn't have any, like, sounds or anything, but it's pretty cool for hiding your stuff, for having a haunted mansion with curtains. That would be freaky. Okay. Next we have the factory door. So, basically this goes into the block above and below. So, as you can see, it makes that cool door sound and look. So that's pretty much a factory door. It goes with like a dark, like, theme. This looks more like a, like, secret dark factory. Anywho, next we have a laboratory door, which basically goes in two blocks up. So let me just show you, it goes in two blocks up. So let's just get some chiseled sandstone. Just like this. Laboratory door, as you can see, it goes up into that. And then, yeah, so, pretty cool. Next we have the Shoji door. I think that's how it's pronounced. Or Shoji door. And you basically right click it. It has a slow opening and closing animation. It closed on me. Ow. So, and it goes into the box beside it, so. Why can't I Why am I breaking everything in my mod lab? What's up with this? Okay, next we have the saloon door. And basically you can place two, and you either need a redstone signal or you just walk through it. You just walk through it. You literally don't do anything else. It has a swinging motion, but it's silent. It'd be cool if you had like So next we have the wooden glass door, and why am I forgetting to show you all these recipes? Okay, curtain crafted with wool in this, just like regular door. Factory door is gold and iron in this crafting recipe. Laboratory door is gold and iron in that recipe. Zoology door is wood and paper. And the saloon door is wood, sticks, and wood in that crafting recipe. Wooden door, which I'm about to go over, whatever, is wood, glass, wooden glass. And I didn't say wooden glass, I said wood and glass. Okay. And then you just do this, makes that sound. That would be the coolest thing. Okay, so basically like that, and then same with the iron glass door, only it's iron ingots, and it does the same thing, only it needs a redstone signal. So if we go into here, open this door, open the curtain, close it, we come to a rusty hatch. Yay! And you pretty much just open it. I'm pretty sure I have the recipe in here. And it has this cool animation. And you can still drop through it if it's not closed. This is the only door that you can't like go through it while it's opening, so right now you can't go through it until it's done with the animation. Sneak peek. I did put it in here. I am a fail. Okay. So let's just go to the rusty hatch and the rusty ladders. So basically, to craft the rusty hatch, it is iron and a rusty handle, which is crafted with iron. So everything's crafted with iron or wood or gold, and some things are crafted with other things. So let's close this. It would be cool if you needed like. It would be cool if they added like a key and you needed a key for some of the doors. That would be cool. That would be awesome. So, rusty ladder is just iron in that crafting recipe because everything is made out of iron. Let's put that in there. And let's get these. So, basically, a sliding trapdoor, you can just right click it with your hand. It has the same animation as the other door. I think it was the sliding glass door, I think it is. Anywho, we have an iron trap door, which is also in 1.8, so you just open it, you know, that kind of thing. And it has the same animation for another, what is this called? Never mind. My brain got lost. Okay, so go through this. Open this, and let's go with the garage door because I forgot to do that. So basically, you can just build this as high as you want, as long as you want, and it will pretty much go up. You need a redstone signal though. It will go up and slide backwards. So if your house is like this, have caution. Okay, I think it does that with everything, unless it just goes there, just out of randomness. I'm just gonna test that. Forgetting this. Yep, it goes the opposite way, so please have caution while building. It might hurt you in a big way, unless you have Now we went over those. As you can see, we have a carriage door. And I'm pretty sure it's in here. It opens like this. This is 5 blocks high. So you're gonna need a big library or something big just to fit one of these. And it's pretty much just like a double door, and you can open it and you can have some kind of secret. Oh gosh, that's good. Some kind of secret. And this, I'm pretty sure this is the only door that you can just do this with it. So, now we have, so it's wooden, 2 wooden doors, quartz around it, or quartz pillars, or chisel quartz, I don't really know, I don't really care. And you get yourself a carriage door, so if I just feel like it, I don't want to break that, I could place it again, and then there we go. You have your carriage door. And I'm gonna. So here we have a force field. Stop it. A force field controller, and this is pretty overpowered. So I don't blame it for being so expensive. This is the crafting recipe. 4 diamonds. Yay. 3 redstone repeaters, 1 obsidian, and an eye of ender. And basically what this does is, yes, you said it, it controlled a force field. Dang it. So you can pretty much have a force field. And before I didn't know how to work this, so, I didn't know that you could do this. You could turn it off and on, but now I know that because I've done it. And, yeah. I'm going to leave it on so that no one gets in. So, there's only a few more things. I'm not going to show you everything because then you wouldn't have a chance to. Well, I'm pretty much sure. So, never mind. There are a few other things, but those are things like too complicated for even me. So if I don't show you those things, go to the web page post thing that's going to be in the description, and pretty much just get it from there, because I'm not going to do that. So this is a door factory, and before I forget, let's get both of these. Okay, so basically all this is to craft it is 4 iron ingots, 2 redstone, 1 iron door, and 1 piston, and you get yourself a door factory. Yay, that's not the door. This is, okay. So pretty much all you have to do is get blocks. Oh my gosh, I can't find blocks. Okay, there's a lot of stuff in this mod, so. Okay, so basically you gotta put in your materials. If you want, that is your frame type and 2 wool, like that. You can put in a digicode, so I'm just gonna put in 9. Movement, I'm gonna have sliding up. Opening time is 6, so I'm just gonna leave it like that. Double door, no, because I'm not gonna need it as a double door. Sound type. And then you have yourself a custom door, and it pretty much looks like this. It pretty much looks like this. So, yeah. And then you gotta put in your digicode, 9. You gotta press enter on your keyboard. Opens up, slides up, just like a factory door. And then do that, break it, yay! So next we have a block mixer. So basically all you have to do is mix blocks. Mix blocks like no one even cares. So just put 2 blocks in there and then boom. Boom, got your mixed block, and then I guess I can do it again. I'm just gonna mix blocks until I feel like I'm done, because I want to see how this turns out. Weird, or it's going to be normal. Can't put it back in. So basically, this is how a mixed block looks. It looks like a regular block from this side, but once you look over it, it's pretty weird. So if you want, and it sounds like stone, goodbye. So if you want, just mix blocks to make your house look that slightest bit cooler, then get this mod, and you'll have mixed blocks for days. This is actually kind of useful for like interior stuff. Have like it look like red wool, but on the inside is literally wood, and you're like, what? What? Do you have wallpaper? Teach me how. Okay, so that's just about to be. That's just about going to be the end of this mod review. If you did like this mod, make sure to leave a like and subscribe for more. Just leave any mod you want me to do, even if it counts as the not enough items mod, which I'm using right now. I'll try to put it in the link below. And yeah, I will see you guys in the next video. And I'm sorry I didn't upload Herobrine's Mansion today. So much stuff was going on. It's probably like the only time I had to record a video, and I couldn't really record anything else but a mod review. So yeah, I'll see you guys later. Bye.